Hello, friends. In this video, we will review another version of the relay module designed to work with standard USB ports and controlled via Zigbee. This is not the first such device I've talked about. Links to other reviews will be provided in the description. However, unlike those, this module features not just one but three separate control channels. Versions with one and two channels are also available. We will explore the device's capabilities, as well as its compatibility with various smart home control systems, including the Tuya Smart Ecosystem, Apple HomeKit, Google Home, the Sonoff iHost Control Hub, and, of course, we'll test different integration options with Home Assistant. More details will follow in my video, but for now, as usual, I kindly ask you to like this video to help others interested in smart home topics find it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Type of device, relay USB module. Number of channels, 1, 2, 3. This review focuses on the 3-channel version. Interface, Zigbee. Operating voltage, from 5 to 12 volts. Maximum current, up to 2.5 amperes for the single-channel version, 2 by 1.5 amperes for the 2-channel version, and 3 by 1 ampere for the 3-channel version. Size excluding the USB connector, 32 by 30.4 by 26.3 millimeters. Operating temperature range, from minus 10 to 40 degrees Celsius. The device is delivered in a small blue cardboard box. From the labeling on the box, it is clear that there are also versions with USB-C connectors. A sticker on one side provides information about the specific version of the device inside. In my case, it is the Zigbee version with three standard USB-A connectors. The package includes the device itself and a small instruction manual in English. An interesting note, the instructions explain how to manually reset the device. To do this, press and hold the button on the body for 10 seconds until the blue LED near it starts flashing. The device is housed in a white plastic casing. On one side, it features the output connectors, which in this model are three USB-A ports. The only button on the body, when pressed briefly, turns all the connectors on or off simultaneously. Holding the button puts the device into pairing mode. On the opposite side from the output connectors, there is a USB input for the power source. It is positioned perpendicular to the output connectors. Although I've already mentioned the dimensions, they are easier to visualize next to a standard matchbox. Here it is compared with the Sonoff model, which has a single output connector. You can find a link to that review in the description below the video. Let's move on to studying the functionality of the device and start with the standard Tuya Smart Management System. To use it, a Zigbee gateway is required. I use a wired version with HomeKit support. The relay enters pairing mode automatically after powering on. If this does not happen, press and hold the button on the body until the blue LED near it starts flashing. Once this is done, the relay connects and is added to the system. The plugin has a standard interface, similar to multi-channel relays and switches. Most of the screen is occupied by control buttons for each channel. Below them are additional options such as turning all channels on, off simultaneously, scheduling, and settings. The response is quick, and the channels indeed have separate control. The button controls all channels simultaneously. In this version, the load should not exceed 5 watts per channel. To test data transfer, I connected a flash drive to one of the channels. When the relay is on, access to the data is available. The scheduling menu allows you to set configurations for each relay channel individually. There are several options, including countdown timers, which change the selected channel state to the opposite after a specified time. The scheduler allows you to set specific times and days of the week for turning channels on or off. The circulation feature sets a time period during which the relay alternates between on and off states for a specified duration. There is a random on-off mode within a set time period. The inching mode enables the relay to turn on for a preset time interval from 1 second and then turn off. This can be used for periodic tasks such as watering plants. The settings menu includes only one option, the state after power recovery. This setting is universal for all channels, allowing them to always turn on, turn off, or retain their state prior to the power loss. In the General Settings menu, everything is standard. Compatibility with third-party systems, which we will test shortly, device information, shared access, firmware version, and system removal. The relay can participate in automations. In the If Triggers section, you can track the status changes of each channel and set actions for events such as turning on or off. Countdown timers can also be tracked. In the Then Actions section, you can control each relay channel. Turn it on, turn it off, or toggle its state to the opposite, an option that is often missing in other Tuya Smart devices. You can also set countdown durations. Let's move on to alternative systems. Integration with Google Home is done at the cloud account level, after which all supported devices are automatically added. The relay is supported, and four new objects appeared. These include each relay channel separately and a master switch for all channels. Control works fine, including through the voice assistant. As I mentioned earlier, the gateway I use supports the HomeKit protocol. To check compatibility, I use the Home Assistant integration. In an Apple's native app, everything works the same way. The gateway is connected in bridge mode, and all devices compatible with the protocol appear here automatically. The reviewed device appeared as expected. There is control over all three channels, and it works locally without an internet connection. The memory state setting is not available here, but it can be configured in the Tuya Smart app. While the relay is still connected to the gateway, let's check two more integration options in Home Assistant, and later we'll test setups with alternative coordinators. The first option is the official Tuya integration. It also works via the cloud. To connect, a security code from the app is used, and devices are automatically added to the system. Control for all three relay channels was found here, and everything works correctly. The memory state setting is also available, but the options are labeled with numbers. However, their correspondence can easily be verified via the Tuya app, which continues to work with all the systems we've reviewed so far. The second option for adding the relay to Home Assistant with the standard gateway and app is the Tuya Local integration. Like the official one, it also uses a security code, but this must be entered when connecting each new device. However, it does not depend on the internet. Specify the gateway and the desired connected device. This integration picked up only two of the three control channels, as well as the timers assigned to them. Control works correctly, but it does not include the third relay channel. I assume that for versions with one or two relays, this method will work fully. Now it is time to disconnect the relay from its native gateway and switch to alternative connection methods. Let's start with the Sunoff iHost Smart Home Control Center with firmware version 2.4.1 current at the time of this video. It is equipped with its own Zigbee coordinator, which allows such devices to be connected directly. The relay was detected and added to the system. The system could not find a suitable icon, so the Tuya ecosystem logo was used instead. The R symbol in the upper right corner indicates that the device functions as a Zigbee router. Control for all three channels was found, and everything works correctly. Standard settings for this type of device are also available. A scheduler for turning the relay on and off by time and days of the week is available for each channel. This option functions as a countdown timer, switching the selected relay channel to the opposite state after a set time interval. In the settings, you can assign custom names to the device and each control channel separately, as well as set a location. No other settings were found here, including behavior after power recovery. The relay can be used in automations. This is part of the Triggers section, which defines the events that activate the relay. Only state changes for each of the three channels are available. For relays, the Actions section is more applicable. For each channel, you can choose to turn it on, turn it off, or toggle its state. The iHost can connect to other systems in bridge mode using the Matter protocol. In my case, it is connected to Google Home. Via Matter, the relay is also integrated into Google Home. Unlike the previously demonstrated method, this option does not depend on the internet. Control for all three channels is available, but there is no master switch. Let's return to Home Assistant, but this time we will use alternative Zigbee coordinators instead of the native Tuya gateway. We'll start with the ZHA integration and a USB Zigbee stick with SkyConnect firmware. When the relay is disconnected from the previous gateway or coordinator, it automatically enters pairing mode. This is convenient because physical access to the device is not required. In ZHA, the reviewed device was detected and many objects were found. In addition to separate control for each channel, ZHA displayed energy monitoring sensors. I believe this is due to the use of a template firmware with extra data that the system displayed. There is also control for the indicator light, firmware version, and memory state. The indicator light is an unnecessary object. Changing its settings has no effect. Behavior after power recovery works correctly here. I checked it, and the setting applies to all relay channels at once. By default, the switches were identified as lights, but this is easy to change directly in the interface. Energy monitoring does not work, so these sensors are better disabled, which can also be done through the settings. Lastly, let's test compatibility with ZigBee 2 MQTT. I am using release 2.0.0, which was highly discussed at the time of testing. I disconnect the relay from the SkyConnect coordinator, after which it automatically enters pairing mode and connects to the ZigBee 2 MQTT coordinator. The device is supported, although it currently lacks an icon. It was identified as a three-channel relay, which is accurate. By default, channel control is available, and everything works correctly, but the behavior after power recovery setting is missing. Let's try to fix this. The solution to this problem is to create an external converter. Initially, I took the easiest approach, using an automatic generator. It is located on the Dev Console tab. Press the generation button. It generates this code. Let's try using it as is, by default. Note that in versions 2.0.0 and higher, external converters are not added manually. They must be created in the external_converters folder within the addon folder and are automatically loaded from there. I create an empty file in this folder, naming it with the device identifier and using the .js extension. I insert the code from the generator. I only change the description in it, though there are clearly unnecessary elements, such as energy monitoring. But let's test it as is for now. To apply the converter, the ZigBee 2 MQTT addon must be restarted. With the default converter, energy monitoring sensors appeared, confirming my theory about the use of template firmware. However, the memory state setting, which was the goal, is still missing. Further attempts to modify the generated code did not yield results. Removing energy monitoring was easy, but there was a problem with configuring behavior after power recovery. Enabling this parameter resulted in individual settings for each channel, but they did not work because the setting is actually universal for all channels. Therefore, I had to use an old, proven method. I found a suitable three-channel relay with the same model number and memory state support. In the list of official converters, which I will link in the video description, I found this relay. I used it to create my own converter based on the standard template for TUI devices, which includes links to the necessary libraries. I only needed to replace the manufacturer identifier, model, and device description. The link to the converter code will also be provided in the video description. I also disabled the selection of an external mechanical switch type and the status indicator, as they are not present here. I reload the addon. ZigBee 2 MQTT, when detecting an external converter for a device, prioritizes it even if the device is officially supported. This is how the relay looks when using my custom converter. In addition to control for each relay channel, there is now also a memory state setting, which works perfectly as intended. I tested all the statuses. Upon powering on, all relay channels can either turn on, turn off, or restore their state from before the external power was disconnected. All these options are also integrated into Home Assistant via MQTT, and everything works correctly. The versions of all systems, integrations, and add-ons are current as of the video release date. I consider this device to be very successful, especially given its price. The standard USB interface allows it to be used for a variety of tasks, such as controlling lighting, cooling stands for laptops, power cycling various devices, and more. The relay can easily be backed up with a power source, making it an autonomous ZigBee router. Its advantages also include data transfer support and broad compatibility with smart home management systems. That's all for now. I hope this video was useful and interesting for you. I would greatly appreciate your likes, as they help promote the video on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new videos, subscribe to my channel. In the video description, I will include links to stores where you can order this gadget, my Telegram channels, social networks, and groups for discussing smart home topics. Join us, it will be interesting. Thank you for your attention. See you next time, and peace to all.